So here's how this one works. It's not quite as user-friendly as Tabular. This is always one of the first questions on my differential equations test when I teach it. It's a circular integration by parts problem. It's a different type problem that you approach with circular. Tabular, you know to use tabular right away when you've just got a power of x and some other function. Because you know that eventually if you take enough derivatives, you know that the derivative will go to zero. So that's the only time you know absolutely for sure to use tabular. All right, so here's where we use circular integration by parts. This is used when we have a combination of an exponential function and by that I mean e raised to some coefficient times x. Multiplied by a sine or cosine function. So when you think about the types of functions that are involved here, can you guess why this might be called circular? What's the derivative of sine? What's the second derivative of sine? Negative sine, right? Yeah. So I started with sine. I took two derivatives. Where did I end up? Back at sine, right? Or a sine function. What's the derivative of e to the x? E to the x. And if I take a derivative again, I get e to the x. I keep cycling back around to the same derivative. And it's the same with integration. If you integrate cosine, what do you get? Sine. What do you get if you integrate it again? Negative cosine. You're back to a cosine function. So you keep going around in circles with these. You keep ending back up at the same derivative or the same integral. That's why they call this circular. Not because necessarily it involves a unit circle. It's because you feel like when you're working the problem, you keep going around in circles. Okay, so here's what happens with this one, and this will make more sense when we work a problem, but I'm going to go ahead and tell you what's going to happen with it. After the second integration, the term on the far right will be a like term with the original integral.
And so what you will do is you will combine those like terms. To isolate the integral. And after you do that, then the right side will be your answer. So that's how this works. Okay. Let's look at an example. I want you to look at problem number 36. On page 533. And here's the integral they've given us. And it is a combination of sines and cosines. Now, when you're doing circular integration, it really absolutely does not matter which one of these you call U and which one of them you call V. That's just a preference. So we're either going to end up with fractions in thirds or fractions in fifths. Do you have a preference there? Thirds or fifths?
Fifths.
Fifths? Okay. If we're going to end up with fractions in fifths, we will integrate the sine function. So, in our first round of integration, we're going to call U E to the negative 3x. And we're going to call dv sine 5x dx. So our du will be negative 3e to the negative 3x dv. I'm sorry, dx, not dv. I'm looking at dv. And then V will be negative 1/5 cosine 5x. And we'll start out the way we did before using our formula, except that we have to remember to write the left side this time. So the left side is our original integral. And the reason we have to hang on to it is because later on it's going to be a like term with something else. So our uv is going to be negative 1/5 e to the negative 3x cosine 5x. And then our v du, let's see, we've got negative 3 times negative 1/5, so that's a positive 3/5, and then we subtract it because in the formula it's minus the integral. So I'm going to put the 3/5 outside. And then we are left to integrate our e to the negative 3x cosine 5x. We know we're not ready to put anything together yet because the left side and the last term on the right side are not like terms yet. Need to get those two to match. So we're going to have to go one more round before we can get a match. So we're going to start over. Our U this time is still going to be our e to the negative 3x. No, because you had a negative v and a negative du, so that became positive. But in the formula, it's minus that integral. So minus a positive is still negative.
Okay,
I know, you have to really think about the signs when you're doing this. You got to be careful. All right, our dv this time is our cosine 5x dx. All right, so we're going to keep our original integral again. We'll keep our first term. And then we have this negative 3/5 that's going to multiply. Now we'll start over with u times v. So, oh, I didn't get. Okay. Well, we know du is going to be the same as before. So I need to get v up here. I didn't do that for y'all. Let's see where I left it out. Right here. This v is going to have to be 1/5 sine 5x. Your du for e to the negative 3x is going to be the same as your du before, negative 3 e to the negative 3x. So here we can just refer to this same du up here. No, we integrated. Cosine integrates to positive sine. Okay. So where were we? 3/5. Okay. So u times v is again going to be 1/5. And now we're going to have e to the negative 3x sine 5x. And then minus the integral v du. But this time, our du is negative. Our v is positive. So that integral would have started out negative. And we're subtracting it. So this becomes a plus. And then this term is going to be, yeah, let's pull the 3/5 to the outside. So we're going to have e to the negative 3x sine 5x. Now, notice on this last term, you've got this negative 3/5 here. And a 3/5 here, right? So this last term, I have negative 3/5 times negative, no, times positive 3/5. So I'm going to get a negative 9 over 25, right? And that will be e to the negative 3x sine 5x dx. That's what my last term ends up being. Does that make sense? I'm going to take this term right here, and I'm going to combine it with this term right here, because now they are like terms. Now they both have the same integral. So what we're going to end up doing is we're going to end up adding a 1, because there's no coefficient out in front of that integral, with 9 over 25, because when I move the other integral over to the left side, it's going to change signs. So this will be 25 over 25 plus 9 over 25. So we're going to end up with a coefficient of 34 over 25. I'm going to switch screens in a minute, but let me ask if there are any questions about anything we've done so far. Are we good so far? Yeah. Okay. All right, so we've got 34 over 25. Because on the other side, on the left side, our integral didn't have a coefficient. Remember from algebra, anytime there's not a written coefficient, what do we always make the assumption is there? A 1. Because I can multiply by 1 without changing the value. Okay. So on the left side, we now just have this integral. And on the right side, we have everything but the integral now, right? We have our negative 1/5 e to the negative 3x cosine 5x. And then we have our negative 3 over 25 e to the negative 3x sine 5x. And then all we have to do to finish solving this problem is multiply on both sides by the reciprocal, right? So we would multiply by 25 over 34 on both sides. And that would leave us just the integral on the left side. Go ahead and distribute it. That way you get your final answer completely correct. So 1/5 times 25 over 34 is going to be 5 over 34, and that one was negative. Because you had a negative 1/5 out there. Yeah, and the 25 and the 5 cancel, right? And then this one would be what? What would be my coefficient on this one? 3 over 34. What's that? Oh, okay. Well, that's a good quality to have. You can answer your own question. All right. Now, I'm going to leave off there for the lecture, because I want to get everybody's test back. But we also need to talk, because I have held y'all over enough to make up the time we missed. We're still not caught up. So I am willing to go back to 50-minute classes, if that's what y'all would like to do. I personally love having the extra time because we can go slower, but I'm not going to do that unless that's something you want to do. So between now and tomorrow, I want you to think over whether you as a class want to go back to just 50-minute classes
And I'm fine if you do, because that's all you're legally required to be here. Or if you would rather have the extra time so we can go slower. And just talk that over amongst yourselves. And it has to be a unanimous decision if we keep meeting longer. If it's not a unanimous decision, then what I'll do is I'll do regular lectures. And then anybody who wants to stay, we can work on homework.
Could we even do something to where, like, if we did start staying longer, maybe try to build in review days?
Possibly. Y'all just think it over and talk it over amongst yourselves. Because I'm not going to keep you longer than you're supposed to be here if you don't want to do that. But if you feel like it would be beneficial to you to have the extra time, or if you would rather me do homework problems or something else in the extra time so that those who need to leave can feel comfortable leaving, I'll be glad to do that too. Let me grab my grade book out, and then I need your quizzes from yesterday.
Can you go to the previous screen?
If it'll come back up, I can.
You need the screen before this one? Yes. Okay, so when you come up, have your quiz ready for me to look at. And then after I look at your quiz, you need to dig your test out of the pile and hand it to me to stick a grade on it so that can go in the grade book. And they are no longer in alphabetical order. And Jonathan, I will grade yours as soon as I get done grading everybody's quizzes. Is that okay? Okay. All right. So here are the tests. Be sure you do not leave with a test until I have written the grade for that test down in the grade book. If I don't have the grade written down, guess what grade gets written down? It is not an A, I will tell you that. All right. So first come, first serve out here. All right, so this is 8.2, number 22, and today is the 19th. Okay. All right, Jay, you may sign. Let me see your tests, please. You can have that back. I just needed to look at it. And you may keep your test as well. Okay. You may sign.